Hello everyone, I'm Neetu Chaudhary. Welcome to my channel, Continuous Improvement. It is said that knowledge and data is a new oil, and organizations are focusing more on knowledge management now. Knowledge is of two types, explicit and tacit. Explicit knowledge is more easy to manage because it's more physical and tangible. So it's something like the fire exit plan or the documents you are making or the standard operating procedures we are making, frequently asked questions, triage questions, the help documents, user manuals. All these comes under explicit knowledge. But there is more. It's like a glacier. The 1/8 is your explicit knowledge, but the 7/8 is your tacit knowledge. And tacit knowledge is very difficult to capture, because it is something in brain of people, and when they leave the organization, it goes with them. So now organizations are focusing more on capturing this information. What is this tacit knowledge? Tacit knowledge is something we learn by doing something by our experience. It is like something learning the recipe from the grandmother, or the storytelling, sharing the experience, telling stories of success and failure. KT, hands-on practices, and sharing the situation, scenario planning, all these comes under the tacit knowledge. So when organization focus on knowledge management, they need to focus on both explicit and tacit knowledge. In fact, more on tacit knowledge, because it's real and it's more experience-based learning from people. But how to do that? Well, there are a few things which can help organizations in capturing tacit knowledge. The first is organization culture for collaboration. The more teams will collaborate with each other and share knowledge informally or formally, like during the coffee time or during some informal or formal meetings. And by breaking the silos, this tacit knowledge can be captured. Breaking silos between departments and within department, between different sections and different teams. Once a silo is broken, then people can communicate more openly with each other to share this knowledge. The second is mentorship programs at the micro level, not at the very high level, the leadership program. That is a different benefit. For tacit knowledge, we need to have the mentorship program at the very micro level. When somebody had some experience of resolving some issue or doing something, they need to share it with other teams by mentorship program, the formal program. The next option is video and voice data we can record. Like if something is, some experience is there by resolving the issue, so the video can be captured or the voice messages with the hashtag, which can be easily retrieved and fast it can be analyzed and used by other teams. The next is the focus teams or the different forums, the social media could be used internally within the organization. So as and when any experience happens, people can send voice message or videos, or they can share the information over there, upload documents. So it can be communicated with the wider audience within the organization. And the last one is training by practitioners, the person who is actually experiencing it and doing the things. If that person gives the training, not only the documented things will be shared, but the learning, the actual experience, how the things go wrong and what to do to resolve them will also be shared during those training sessions. So training by actual practitioner has a lot of impact on capturing tacit knowledge.